So this is India now reverting back to its classical system of taxation, which was dividends to be taxed in the hands of shareholders. Interestingly, India is the only country in the world which until now had companies to pay an additional dividend distribution tax. What this will mean is that though companies will be relieved from the burden of paying an additional dividend distribution tax, all dividends will now become taxable in the hands of shareholders. It will have multiple effects. For example, let's take corporates. Suppose corporates are recipients of dividends. The finance minister did say that for holding companies, she will provide suitable deduction mechanisms so that there is no cascading of that tax. Secondly, I think for foreign investors, this is a big boost because they had a triple whammy under the dividend distribution tax. First, corporate tax, company paying dividend distribution tax, and worst of all, these dividends were not exempt in their hands in overseas countries. So they were paying an additional tax on those dividends without getting any credit for the dividend distribution tax paid for by the company. Now under tax treaties, they will be able to get credit for tax withholding, and under India's treaties, withholding taxes is only from 5% to 15%. So net at a group level, it's possible that they may get some reduction in taxes. So for them also, it is beneficial. Another important feature is that most dividends when received by corporates, tax officers were applying the provisions of Section 14A, which basically says that if you are earning any exempt income, we will not allow you any expenditure against that. And the way they were calculating that expenditure was an artificial rule 8A in the income tax rules, where a huge portion of normal expenditure, not even related to earning dividends, was being disallowed. With dividends now becoming taxable, 14A therefore becomes obsolete, and a huge cause of dispute will also die down. Well, the promise is that the taxes will be reduced. In order to go to that mecca of reduced taxes, you will have to now do a complex calculation to see what deductions and exemptions you are already claiming in your tax return. If you have to forgo those, then what is under the new regime your tax? So each individual will have to decipher for her or him what is more beneficial, whether the new regime or the old regime. But clearly, therefore, it's not an unalloyed gift, it's not a giveaway, it's not a reduction. It comes in with a cost, and each individual will need to see what's the cost in his or her hands before making a decision whether to opt for the new regime or to continue under the old regime. So I think they did gross calculations. They would have just, you know, to my mind, again, one doesn't know how the budget math is worked out. But let's say I would plot notional incomes and at higher slab rates, calculate the tax, at lower slab rates, calculate the tax, give some credit for, you know, maybe deduction under ATC, etc., and then make a rough and ready calculation of giving a 40,000 crores. But I don't think it's as simple as arriving, because as I explained to you, it's so complex in the hands of individual shareholders. Now take a situation, somebody is paying a mediclaim policy, somebody is covered by the company and not paying it. So for the guy who is paying it, he has to claim a deduction. For the guy who is anyway not paying it, for him that deduction is meaningless. So I think it's a bit more complex than what perhaps the calculation may show. Oh, that's a very positive step. If you recall, in 2014, the Income Tax Department had come out with a charter which was purely voluntary. That piece of paper was printed on every, stuck on every tax office, you know, let's say corridors. However, in actual practice, some of that did not translate into actual action. So for example, one of the important features of that charter was time limits laid down for customer service. So for example, processing of all your tax refunds within 3 months to 6 months. Processing of all your tax appeals within a period of 2 years. Now of course, one will have to see what the new legislation is providing. But if time limits are given, then to hold the department accountable in a time-bound manner would be a very positive step.